I gotta start the intro.
What is up, everybody? As you know, we got called out to go race Street Speed 717, Guitarmageddon ZL1, Diablo Formula Racing, Dirty Max Jack, all those guys, Cletus McFarland with Leroy. So we gotta go to Cecil County Dragway next month, so it's time to get the car ready. We've been wanting to do for a while a what it takes to beat a demon with a Hellcat, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna have the car hopefully ready in time for the race. First thing we're gonna do today is put in a drive shaft. I got a dead body underneath the car already. Here is the new drive shaft from the drive shaft shop. Good to 1,000 horsepower. Didn't get the carbon fiber one because I've seen some of them shatter. So far I've only seen one, I only know of one or two people that have broke these. So we'll be perfectly fine with these. Definitely beefy. And so we're gonna put that on today. Josh is here to help me. So first thing we had to do is jack up the car, which I did. And then we gotta take part of the exhaust off to get the drive shaft out, and then we can put this puppy back in. There she is. What are you doing under there?
I'm waiting for some tools.
What do you need?
The Torx.
What and size?
I don't remember.
All right. So first we gotta take the coupler off the back. With the Torx bit, don't know what size. But I'm sure I have one that fits. And then we gotta take this, lighting's terrible, this brace off here so we can get the exhaust out the way. There's my muffler deletes welded in there. Is that it?
Yeah, it should work.
So 13 millimeter to take this brace off. There's two nuts on each side. I don't know what this big puddle of water is under there.
Did they see how one came in, didn't
they? I wasn't driving it. I'm gonna take this brace off. So,
it's just gonna park.
Gotta pop that little end off there, which is for the parking, so we can turn the drive shaft to get all the bolts out. This is a pain in the ass on the ground.
True.
We take this heat shield off. A couple bolts that hold it on. I think they're like a 10. Maybe, yeah, about a 10. Luckily, I still have my 10 millimeters. I've bought many extras over the years. They always go missing.
They don't go missing, they just walk off.
But we're taking the back half of the exhaust off. Since I have a cat back, I don't think we're gonna have to take the mid pipes off. So we're gonna try with just the back half here. For those concerned about safety, we do have a jack on each side, as well as two jack stands that the car's sitting on, and two sitting there while we're underneath here, just in case. So settle down, everybody. While I finish taking these off, they are Loctited in, so they never get loose until the very end. So I literally have Popeye forearms right now. Here is the stock drive shaft versus the 1,000 horsepower drive shaft. Big difference. What a piece of crap. Well, now you can see why we have to replace them. Two piece, very small and flimsy, literally tiny compared to this one, which is also why they had to put a new drive shaft for the Demon. So there you go. Josh got this one out. Now we're gonna slap the new one in. Look at that. What a piece of crap.
Try now. Any better?
Yeah.
Okay, so you hook up the adapter.
Torque them to what we believe is 57 from searching online, because it didn't come with any information in the box. Which seems awfully light, but
I think that's what mine were, 57 and 70.
What do I know? Put the new drive shaft in, put the exhaust back on, and we're ready for 1,000 horsepower. Putting the new shaft on. Got the coupling on the front and the back. This is a little bit bigger pain in the ass than I thought it would be, honestly.
Do these first.
There's the front. First thing I didn't video because I was underneath here, but you got to put on the adapter there. It bolts to the output of the transmission, and then you bolt it, the drive shaft to it. Drive shaft bolts to the adapter we put in the back. And you want to line up the little line that they put on there. See the blue line on the two pieces match, because that's how it was set up when they balanced it. Josh is torquing down the front to 57 foot-pounds. Very little room to work. And then we gotta do the back, four bolts on the back to 70. I heard a click. Not awesome at all. But this is 6061 aluminum, which is pretty badass. We got it done. Let's see your hands. Yeah, you worked. Josh kicked butt. We're dirty. We got it on. It's done. That was a pain in the ass. Now we don't have to worry about breaking the drive shaft. We got drag radials and wheels coming in tomorrow or the next day, and then Josh and I are going to the track Friday night. Only an eighth mile. That's the closest thing that we can find that has an open night. So we're gonna run, see what it does stock, and hopefully Josh will be able to get 6.5.
What we're shooting for.
6.5 for Josh, which would be really awesome. Low tens. Would that be low tens in the quarter?
6.85 was 10.6 or so in the quarter. So I think 6.4s or nines, high nines.
So look at the inching down towards nines. Run that mission to beat the demon. It's like I'm standing on a mountaintop, mountaintop. I got the feeling I'ma never drop, never drop. I leave that mountaintop and touch the stars, stars. All these verses take me, I feel like I'm close to God, God. It's like I'm standing on a mountaintop, mountaintop. I got the feeling I'ma never drop, never drop. I leave that mountaintop and touch the stars, stars. All these verses take me, I feel like I'm close to God. Testing these lyrics, I'm feeding the needy. I'm seeing they need me, I'm giving these meals. Blessing the